Hello everyone, myself Mr. Manoj Patil, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department at Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samajas, Karmavir Advocate Baburao Ganpatrao Thakre, College of Engineering, Nashik. Dear student, today we are going to discuss about sources of sewage, then variations in sewage flow, then flow quantity estimation, and lastly, example on determination the quantity of maximum sewage flow. Dear student, the today's lecture objectives are, means after completion of today's lecture, student, you will be able to explain the sources of sewage, then you will understand the variation in sewage flow, and you will be able to determine the quantity of maximum sewage flow. See student, first one is the sources of sewage or wastewater flow. See student, there are various sources of sewage are there from which this sewage or wastewater is to be generated, like domestic source, industrial source, public source, then private wells and other sources, then lake and canal and well sources, then groundwater infiltration sources and storm water sources. So these are the various sources of sewage are there from which the sewage is generated. Now we will discuss one by one in detail. See, first one is the domestic source. Domestic source, it is one of the important sources which is to be contributed majorly for the generation of this sewage. See student, this domestic source is distributed or classified into the residential source, then the institutional source, like, okay, means the wastewater which is to be generated from the residential area, from the institutional area, from the commercial building, whatever the wastewater or sewage is to be generated, that will come under this domestic source. Then industrial source. See, this industrial source means the wastewater which is to be generated from the industry, that will come under this industrial source. See, the quantity of wastewater generated from different industry, it is different, okay, according to the size of that industry, then the quantity of the, or the quality, what kind of the raw material is to be utilized, okay. So depending on the generation of wastewater is to be there in industrial source. Then the public source, okay, means the wastewater which is to be generated from the, like the water which is to be utilized for the gardening purpose, for cleaning the roads, okay, from that, whatever the wastewater is to be generated, that will come under this public source. Then private wells and other sources. See student, the peoples are having their certain bore wells or private wells, from that bore wells or private wells, whatever the wastewater is to be generated, that will come under this private wells source. Then lake and canal and well sources. See student, this lake, canal and well water is also contributed for the generation of the sewage or wastewater. Then the groundwater infiltration sources. So whatever the rainwater is there or the groundwater infiltrations are there, that are also contributed for the generation of the wastewater. And lastly, storm water sources. So storm water sources, it is also one of the important source which is to be contribute for the generation of the sewage. Now next part is the variation in the sewage flow. See student, whatever the sewage flow is there or wastewater flow is there, that wastewater flow is not constant always. That wastewater flow is varied from time to time, from season to season, or from month to month. That sewage flow is fluctuating, okay. So see, what is this variation in sewage flow and why this variation in sewage flow, understanding of this variation of sewage flow is important. See, the per capita demand of water, if we are consider that as a Q, and the corresponding per capita sewage production is Q dash, based upon the annual flow, and therefore we can define this as the average daily flow per person. Okay? See, student, we know that whatever the water which we have to supply to the people, okay, so out of that 75 to 80% of water is generated as a waste water. So this average value is not sufficient, although this value is very important for the design of the various components of the sewage system, because there are wide variation in the actual flow through the sewer at a given time. So see, student, whatever the wastewater flow in the sanitary sewers are there, that flow is fluctuates seasonally, monthly, daily, as well as hourly also. See, we know that during the morning time, whatever the wastewater flow is there, that wastewater flow is high or maximum during the morning time from 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. or 10 a.m. as compared to your other daytime. As compared to your afternoon or at evening, whatever the sewage flow is there, that is less as compared to your whatever the sewage flow which is at morning time. So this sewage flow is always varies or fluctuate. See, student, the peak flow will be much greater for smaller lateral sewer as compared to those for the larger trunk sewer. And the minimum flow passing through a sewer is also important factor in the design of sewer, because if the sewer is not carry or pass that wastewater, so what happens? Whatever the inorganic suspended matters or solids are there, that are settled at the bottom of that sewer, and that sewer may get blocked. So the minimum flow that should be passed through the sewer, that is also important, because at low various section that will reach the causing point after the various times of flow. Okay, that's why this is very important whenever we are account the sewage. See, student, there are various factors are there, the variation in the sewage flow, that is due to the various factors are there. Like first one is the types of industry, means what type of industry is there. Okay, depending upon that, that sewage is also varied. Then the habits of people. Okay, so what are the habits of people? According to that, sewage flow is varied. Climatic condition also play a role in the variation of the sewage flow. Then the timing of the water supply, at what time the water is supplied to the people, that is also important in the variation of the sewage flow. So these are the various factors which are affecting the variation in the sewage flow. Now next part is the flow quantity estimation. This is very important. Why this flow quantity estimation is important? See, student, whenever we are designing the sewer line or sanitary sewage system, so at that time, how much quantity of the flow is to be generated, that we should know. Otherwise, what happens if we are not consider the quantity of wastewater is to be generated? So, and if we design randomly the sewer line, so what happens? It may get inadequate, or it may get too much high. So to achieve the economy, to save the cost, so proper how much quantity of wastewater is to be generated, their estimation is very, very important. And according to that, we should design that sewer system. So see, student, the quantity of the wastewater depends upon the following addition and subtraction. Okay, so first one is the addition due to the unaccounted private water. Means you have to add the water from the private water. Means some peoples are having their own wells, their own bore wells. Okay, generally what happen, whatever municipal corporation authority are there, they consider the only data, whatever the amount of water is supplied to the people, and out of that 75 to 80% of water they are considered as a wastewater. But they don't consider the private water supply. So you should consider the addition due to the unaccounted private water, then the addition due to the infiltration of the water, then the subtraction due to the losses of water. Because whenever water is supplied to the people, at that time some water is get lost due to the faulty leakage, okay, due to the theft. So you should subtract that Then subtraction due to the water not entering in the sewerage system means sometime whatever the sewage or wastewater is generated that is not come enter into the sewerage system, that you should also consider. So see student, this estimation of quantity of domestic sewage mainly depends on the following factor. First one is the population growth, means how much is the population growth of that particular area. Then the types of areas served, in which area water is to be served. Then the rate of water supply, how much quantity of water is supplied to the people. Okay, then the rate of groundwater filtration. So all these factors are very very important and we should consider, okay, whenever we are calculate the quantity of wastewater is to be generated. Now see student, flow quantity estimation. For the estimating the sewage discharge, okay, so this various equation or formulas we have to use. See, for areas of moderate size such as involved for the branch sewer, the maximum daily or hourly sewage flow that can be calculated by using this equation. First one, maximum daily flow, it is the 2 times the average daily flow. Then your maximum hourly flow, it is 1.5 times the maximum daily flow, or it is 3 times the average daily flow. Then minimum daily or hourly sewage flow are given as the maximum daily flow, it is 2/3 times the average daily flow, and minimum hourly flow, it is 1/2 time minimum daily flow or 1/3 time of the average daily flow. So from that you can easily calculate the maximum daily flow or hourly sewage flow and minimum daily or hourly sewage flow. Now see student, next one is the example on the determination the quantity of the maximum sewage flow. So how to calculate, determine the quantity of maximum sewage flow? Very simple example is here. See, determine the quantity of maximum sewage flow generated from the town having population of 40,000 and water supply rate of 150 liter per capacity per day. Take peak factor of 3. See student, first of all you have to write down the given. What is given in the problem? So total population of town is given to you, that is 40,000. Then daily water supply rate, that is 150 liter per capita per day, and peak factor is 3. So first of all, what you have to do? You have to find out the total amount of water supply to the town. So see here, total water supply, that is population is 40,000 and the rate of water supply is 150 and the peak factor is 3. So whenever we are doing the multiplication of this, we will get the total water supply to the city. So that is 40,000 into 150 into 3, that is 18,000 meter cube per day. This much quantity of water is supplied. Now next part is the to find out the total quantity of sewage generated. See student, whatever the water is supplied to the people, out of that 75% to 80% of water is generated as a wastewater. So if we assume that 80% of total water supply is the amount of sewage generated per day, so in this case the total sewage generated, it is 18,000 into 80%, that is 0.8. so total sewage generated is how much? 14,400 meter cube per day. This much quantity of wastewater is to be generated. So in this way we can easily calculate or determine how much quantity of maximum sewage flow is to be generated. So see student, for practice purpose you have to solve this example, that is determine the quantity of maximum sewage flow generated from a town having the population of 1 lakh and the water supply rate is 150 LPCD, and you have to take the peak factor 3. Here population is 1 lakh and the rate of water supply is 150, and you have to take the peak factor 3. Okay, same problem is there, only the values are changed, so you have to solve it as a practice. So these are some references which you have to refer to make this presentation. Thank you student, thank you so much. If you have any difficulty regarding this today's lecture, you can ask me frankly. Thank you so much.